Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Tonight we can have a seat in the camp. Praise the Lord. Tonight is indeed another wonderful privilege that we are all here in His presence. Praise the Lord. And we know that in the presence of the Lord, there is fullness of joy. Amen. On His right hand is pleasure forevermore. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Tonight, believers are endeavoring to be as short as possible because, as I said, I just want to meet with some of the folks for a few minutes after service. Praise the Lord. But tonight, we give God praise and thanks for His love and kindness. Amen. We have much to give God praise for. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Bless the Lord. We have just come through, or we just came through another general election in our country. Praise the Lord. And we thank God that there were no casualties there, and everything runs smoothly. Yeah.
Amen.
We know that there are some concerns on one side in relation to the results, but we live in a democratic country, yeah? And democracy must be a right to every citizen of the country, yeah? So the other side would have asked for a count of the votes in the bachelor seat. And that is the democratic rights of any one of the sides that wants recount. However, I am a bit concerned, and as a man of God, I am truly concerned with what I am hearing and seeing happening in our little and beautiful country, Trinidad and Tobago. You know, just recently we had a spike in racialism in the United States of America that spread throughout the world in terms of we had folks protesting because they wanted to make sure the world knew that Black Lives Matter. I am really taken aback that we have this kind of racism that seems to be pushing up its ugly head in Trinidad and Tobago. And it is a shame that this racism began after a democratic general election was conducted in Trinidad and Tobago. It is a shame. It is not looking good. But I want you to know tonight that we as children of God, it is important, it is imperative that we understand what is the original plan of God, or what was God, or God's original plan for mankind. Amen. It is important that the Christian world continue to teach and to preach the word of God. Let the world know that God has called us to be the human race. Praise the Lord. My God, whatsoever color you might be, whatsoever is the text state of your ear, whether you are white or black or blue or yellow, I will understand that God, He created the human race. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And I will know, hallelujah, praise the Lord, God has created the human race united. Praise the Lord. My God, I wish that we could have gone Facebook tonight, but unfortunately, because of the distance, I will not do so. But praise the Lord. But all faithful friends, definitely, my God, we will share how our concern and our belief with our faithful friends. Amen. Amen. But you know how it is important to understand that when God created us, He created us, hallelujah. He created the human race united. Praise the Lord. My God, whatsoever class you believe that you belong to, whatsoever race you believe that you belong to, whatsoever is your color, whatsoever is your creed, I will give an understanding. God, He created us equally. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You know, in the book of Genesis, chapter 3, and verses 20. Hallelujah. The book of Genesis, chapter 3, and verses 20. The Bible reads, and Adam called. And Adam called his wife named Eve. Why? He called Eve because she was the who? The mother of how many living? The mother of all living. I want you to understand that God created Adam and Eve. And my God, God created the man. He created my God. And He created the woman, how many? Who He took by God a rib out of the man. In Malachi chapter 2 and verse 10, the Bible reads here, have we not all one father? So we have one mother and one father. Have we not all one father? Have not one God created us? Why do we deal so torturously every night against your brother? Why profaning the covenant of our father? My God, we have one father and we have one mother. Hallelujah. My God, it is a shame. It is a shame when you read it and you hear about the racist, my God, talk, my God, all over Trinidad and Tobago. I want you to understand it was never in the hand of God and it is never, it is evil. Hallelujah. And my God, it is time that people understand and know, hallelujah, that we have one father and we have one mother. You see, in verses 20, the Bible said Eve, the Hebrew word there, for Eve, it means life, it means living, it means life spring. If you look at Acts chapter 17, verses 24, the verse 6, the Bible reads it, God of God, hallelujah, Acts chapter 17, verses 24, 26, the Bible reads, God that made the world and all things therein, seeing that He is the Lord of heaven and earth, dwelling not in temples made with hands. Neither is worship with man's hand, as though He needed anything. Seeing He giveth to all life and breath and all things. He giveth to all, and that's some. Hallelujah. He giveth to all life and breath and all things. And I made of one blood. Can someone say one blood? Made of one blood. All nations of men for to dwell on all the face of the earth. And have determined the time before appointed and the bonds of the inhabitation. I want you to understand, God made a man of one blood. Hallelujah. My God, you get yourself in that accident. People are talking about who black and who white and who, my God, is the N word and who, my God, is a G word. And I want you to understand, listen to me, right? You get yourself in an accident. Get yourself in a serious accident and go to the hospital. And my God, and just lie on there dying. And they're about to give you blood. I'm telling them that you want, my God, tell them that you want an live any different by God of the human race. You're better than you ever think again. It's an evil thought. It's a devilish thought. I must not become known. All people have one father in the original created parent. God is not the creator of each person out to die. God is not my God, the creator of each person out to die. Man happened to reproduce. I want you to understand, God did not create Adam and Steve and John and Peter. God created Adam and he created Eve. And my God, and Adam and Eve have to reproduce. And their reproduction is you and I. My God, bury because you are in the wrong place. I want you to understand God has created us to be one. Hallelujah! My God, if you don't feel comfortable among the human race, then my God, let God live in us. Find somewhere else to go live. But I want you to understand God has created us. Hallelujah! One race. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Is it technically God only created one man and one woman? All others are reproduction of the original dead. All others are reproduction of the original dead. God did not create six men and six women. My God are different. My God are here. I'm different. Come on, somebody. I want you to understand all of us. I'm beautiful in the eyes of God. All of us, my God, we are intelligent in the eyes of God. Hallelujah! Oh, what kind of devil is this? There's a devil in the heart of man and woman. God and man and all other creatures power to themselves to reproduce themselves. And I want you to understand, hallelujah, my God, we are a reproduction of our father and mother, Adam and Eve, also to be the child of God, and also to have authority to call him father. Every man that is born of a woman has the right to call God father. He can give his life to God, like a God so loved the world that he gave his own that whom shall ever believe, whom shall ever believe in him, but that perish without everlasting life. It is not my God for the rich and not for the poor. It is not for the white and not for the black. It is not for the yellow. I'm not my God for whatsoever color you might receive your honor. I'm going to understand all that equal. They are equal in the sight of God. Father, have mercy on these people. Those who engage themselves in racism and see man to be different to themselves. It seems like of the many ethnic group in the world, there is one race, and that includes them all, and that is the human race. Hallelujah. There is a basic unity to the human race. For all people share a common origin. All people share a common origin. I said that there. I said that there is a hallelujah. Also a basic equality. I said equality. For all people exist in the image of God. But I want to touch first that there is a basic unity of the human race. For all people share a common origin. You see in Acts chapter 17 and verses 26, The Bible reads it, I made one blood on the nation of men, for to dwell in all the face of the earth. I have taken the time before pointing at the bonds of the inhabitants, as we read just now. Romans 5 and verses 12, the Bible reads in Romans 5 and verses 12, wherefore, as by one man sin entered into the world, and death by sin, and so death passed upon all men, for that all have sinned. How do you understand? You are no different from me. All have sinned, and all have came short of the glory of God, and all have the right to the salvation of God. Hallelujah! You are no different. You are no different than me. Paul said in 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verses 47 and 48. 1 Corinthians 15 verses 47 and 48. Paul said the first man is not the earth's deity. The second man is the Lord of heaven. As it is the earth, such are they also that are earth. And as it is the heavenly, such are they also that are heaven. And thoughts are they also that are happy. How do you understand? Praise the Lord. Paul is saying it is that my God, we have the same flesh. The color of your flesh don't mean that your flesh is different from my flesh. How do you understand? Listen, listen, God. It is the same. Hallelujah. My God, if you are dirty, you are dirty. If you are happy, then be my God. The bond that Jesus put on before he left here, my God, it was that heavenly body. My God, that is a heavenly body. And all bodies are good. All that will put on that same body will be heavenly. Yes, the Bible said, the time is going to come when we, our body shall be changed, and we shall be like him, and we'll put on an heavenly body. But that time is not now. Right now, we live in a dirty body, and all of us, we are equal in body, we are equal in the flesh. Hallelujah! I don't care what is your color. I don't care, my God, if you're born into riches. I don't even understand, my God. You are no better than me. Hallelujah! You are no better than me. I am a servant of the living God. I am blessed. Hallelujah! I am prosperous. I am intelligent. Hallelujah! How do you understand? Listen, listen, God. It is time for you to know that all each of you, hallelujah, my God, you are blessed in the eyes of God. You are intelligent in the eyes of God. I'm seeing people putting up monkeys in a cage. And my God, I created my God, our prime minister, to those monkeys. My God, I'm not who I fought for the people of Trinidad and Tobago. How do you understand this? Whether you are the opposition or you are the prime minister, whether you are whatever race you are, whether you are Indo Trinidad or Afro Trinidad, how do you understand? We all respect each other. Hallelujah! All our respect for each other. If you cannot have respect, my God, for each other, how come you can lead? How can you lead the people? If you don't have respect, my God, for those, hallelujah, who are next to you, hallelujah! How? I'm going to know, my God, this is a serious thing. Serious issues. And my God, we got to be very careful about what we're doing in this place. There is also a basic equality for all people exist in the image of God. I said, Lord, exist in the image of God. And you look at Genesis 1, verse 27. Genesis 1, verse 27. The Bible says, so God created man in his own man, in his own image. And in the likeness of God created he, him, male and female, created he them all. I created my God. I said that there is also a basic equality. Basic equality. There is nothing like class. You hear about class. And my God, I'm going to understand this one is from this class. According to the color of the at this point, come on, somebody. I want you to understand and listen to somebody. If you look at man and woman in the Bible, and you look my God, at one of my God, one man in the Bible that said, my God, I am black, my God, I am black and comely, I am beautiful, come on, somebody. I want you to understand and listen to me. My God, I'm peace. My God, and white, and my God, and straight here, and everything, my God, that you will accept. Hallelujah! I want you to understand this, somebody. You got to understand that God put up, and God is the one who takes up. My God, don't matter how many of us there both in, and go there both, and whosoever you might have bought for, that the end of the day, God is the judge. Amen. My God, both sides work and work the floor, and both sides have been campaigning, and both sides thought that they were men. I want you to understand the power to the end of the day, God is the judge. Hallelujah. He said that one and takes down another. Hallelujah. My God, you can respect that. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. No person is favored with God's salvation on their account of their race. No person is favored with God's salvation on their account of his or her race. All have sinned and are under the judgment of God, but all can be saved through accepting the salvation that God, in his grace and his mercy, has offered to us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, no person, none of us, is favored with God's salvation on their comfortable race. Hallelujah. It can be true. God, I'm looking, and I saw some reading today. My God, people who call themselves a leader, people who call themselves a leader in certain religion, was speaking, or saying, or writing, or texting certain things. And you wonder, my God, listen to this man. Father, if we give the people that chance here in this country, we'll have a caste system. We'll have this group must be here, and this group must be here, and another group must be something else, and this group must be staying on this way, because we must not look equal to that group. How do you understand? Listen to this man. God will not allow that. He will not allow that. God, and I believe in. But God, I believe in, will not allow that. Somebody, I listen. Every creed and race must find an equal place here. We are a multi-ethnic, multi-racial. My God, just one function. How will your nation, how will your nation, how will it let out the space for every creed and every race? How will your my God, and that is how it will be. That is how it will always be. Hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise. Hallelujah. Father, bless your name. I said to you that we are all born in sin. But my God, we have that awful salvation. You know, Paul said in Romans 2, verses 9 and 10. Paul said here in Romans 2, verses 9 and 10. He said, tribulation and anguish upon every soul of man that believeth, of the Jews first and also of the Gentiles. The glory, honor, and peace to every man that doeth working there, to the Jews first and also to the Gentiles. I'm going to answer this to God. Paul was showing you, come to God, that there was a division, there were racial tensions among the Jews and the Gentiles. And Paul was saying, yeah, listen to me, my God, how can a man do good? God, how can you reward that man for doing good? Yeah? Whether you be Jew or you're Gentile, yeah? Whether you be white or you're black, my God, if you're white and you're of this payment that will save you in your whiteness or in your straightness or whatsoever you believe to yourself that is superior than other men. It is in your repent and serve the Lord. Hallelujah. I've got nothing else about you. Hallelujah. Nothing else about you. It's important, hallelujah, that you serve the Lord. Hallelujah. You see yourself, my God, you look at yourself in the mirror, and you see yourself, my God, beautiful, and you see yourself, my God, popular and more, and you think to yourself that you are better than somebody else, but my God, let some sickness get a hold of your body, whether you're white or you're black. I would understand, listen, God. Sometimes it begins to look, my God, like a grave itself. My God, it has nothing to do with even how much money you may have. Oh, hallelujah. I'm saying, young man and young woman of you. There are young men and young women of you who are so discouraged. This week you are hearing them. Some of them, my God, they are angry. They are so angry. You know, my God, my wife had to tell you from the soul. My big daughter, she's very intelligent, and I thank God for that. She just, my God, completed, my God, her law degree. And my God, she is a very intelligent child. But my God, when she look and she see, even my God, persons who she may have grown with, persons who she went to school with, persons, my God, and the things that you're saying because you are supported one side in an election, but if you look at the side you supported in the election, the same people that you are, my God, that you're cursing is the same people that walk around and campaign with you and vote for you, and it's the same people you are calling monkey today. I want you to understand that those people are walking around with you, and those people that will, my God, up the hill and come the hill, and making sure that people walk with you, that you are using these people. My God, and my daughter, she really took it to heart, and she did send out some concerns, and the teacher of the school that she was in, and I'm talking about nothing law school. My God, the school before, the teacher, my God, the message that she sent was so strong that the teacher responded. I think she spoke, she had discussion with the teacher, had discussion with her over a period of time, because my God, her words were so touching that my God, all those who were carrying like that, they became silent on my God, on the media or whatsoever they were on. But I want you to understand, listen, God. We have to be very careful. What's the message we send to our youth? What are the messages we are sending to our youth? These young people that are growing up so intelligent today, what are the messages we are sending to them? Huh? I just thank God, listen, God. I am an Afro-Trinidadian, a proud Afro-Trinidadian. I am, I want you to understand, a successful Afro-Trinidadian in my country. But you know what, hallelujah, I marry a proud and a successful, my God, East Indian woman, my God, in Trinidad and Tobago, hallelujah. I want you to understand, when you walk into my home, in my home, my God, I have three nations. I have one child that my God signified, a clear Afro-Trinidadian, another one that is an Indian, and another one that's a dog. Where are you putting them? Where are you putting the dog child, the Indian child, and the Afro-Trinidadian child? Where are you putting them? Praise the Lord. Yes, my promise Indian wife. Look at her, beautiful. Amen. Beautiful. woman responsible for making me the proud African that I am. Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. What are we doing? What are we doing? Let's make sure that we let the world know and let our country and those who are involved in the racism, they must know that the church, where the church is concerned, is zero tolerance. Yes. Zero tolerance. I am not the preacher that will say silent. I will not stay silent. Zero tolerance. Yes. Praise the Lord. The God has set an altar. And I want to pause. I want to stop. I want to stop tonight. Praise the Lord. Tonight. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Tonight give God praise. Praise the Lord. My wife is reminding me. My wife is reminding me that my grandson is a Madras. Praise the Lord. Where to put them? My God, oh, sister, you are walking.